Today we can discuss about few questions from the chapter dictionary. We studied about dictionary. Dictionary is a combination of key and value, and certain methods of dictionary also we studied. Let's go through the first question. Create a dictionary whose keys are month name and whose values are the number of days in the corresponding month. So you have to create a dictionary. In that dictionary, keys are name of the month and its values are the number of days in each month. Simple question. Everybody can do it. That is not a program. You just want to write a simple single lines answer or single statement. See, I am going to declare a dictionary. D equal to this, you can call it as an empty dictionary. Here we need to specify the month name as the key and value means it's the number of days in that month. So see that I am going to start it here. Month name. Month name is January. See, colon. Total number of days in January. There you can give it a 31. Comma. The next month, Feb. You can give its keyword value part is 28. Like that you can specify there. That is the answer for the first question. You just mentioned the key and its value part inside a dictionary. It's not a program question. You just want to write a single statement. So this is the answer for the first question. Now we can see the next question, second question. What is the second question in this one? What will be the output of the output produced by the following code? So here this is a dictionary question. You have to find the output of this code. So see the dictionary. 5 is the key and its value is number. A is the key, value is string. 1, 2, this is a tuple enclosed in normal bracket. Something enclosed in normal bracket is known as tuple. So 1, 2 is a tuple and its value is tuple. All of you understood now? So here 5 is again, 5 is your key and its value is number. A is key, string is value. This tuple 1, 2, that is together inside a bracket, that is known as tuple. So that tuple is the key and its value is tuple. Now see, next one print statement. So this message will be displayed as it is. Next for loop. For x in d1.keys. For x in d1.keys. So your x variable will get the key values of the dictionary d. So here in this question, it is capital letter D. So here I just use the small letter D. So it will shows the error message. So you have to correct here is small letter D. Because here also I am using the small letter D. So you just correct this part. This is small letter D. Small letter D1 is equal to and this one. Okay. Now see then X in D1.keys. X in d1.key means you will get the keys of the dictionary d1. Keys of the dictionary d1. And that will be stored inside the variable x. So the first key is 5. 5 will be there in the variable x. Understood this much? So the first key is 5, which will be stored inside the variable x. And it is written print x. Print x means how much will be displayed? 5 will be displayed. Colon, colon inside the single quote. So colon will be displayed as it is. Then after that, d1 of x. How much is d1 of x, can you say? X is how much? X is 5. So here d1 of 5. d1 of 5 means what is d1 of 5? d1 of 5 is number. Understood? d1 of 5. d1 dictionary, 5 is the key value, key. And its value is number. So d1 of 5 means you will get the answer number. So the first print statement will give you the answer 5 colon number. 5 colon number and end is equal to end equal to nothing. So empty. So that means 5 colon equal to. Now after that, one more print statement is there. D1 of x into 3. Already we find out that d1 of x is number. Number into 3. So that means there is a replication operator. Indu is the replication operator when you use along with the string, which we already studied. So number into 3. So that means the number will be displayed thrice. After that, there is a print statement is there, empty. Nothing is mentioned inside the bracket. So nothing is there. So automatically cursor will move to the next line. Once again, I'll explain. Here, this is a for loop for x in d1.keys. Means you will get each key from the dictionary d1. Yes, each key from the dictionary. I'll copy this into a Word file. And it is easy for me to explain that also. See here, this is my second question. Now, print dictionary content, x in d1.keys. Means you will get the keys of this dictionary inside the variable x. The first, the value is 5. That will be there in the variable x. And print x. So 5 will be printed. Then colon is there. The colon will be displayed as it is. D1 of x. So D1 of 5. D1 of 5 means you will get the answer number. D1 of 5 is number. Then, so end is equal to empty. So that means the cursor will be there itself. It will not move to the next line. It will not shift it to the next line. The cursor will be waiting there itself. And next, D1 of x into 3. Already we find out here D1 of x is number. So number into 3 means you will get number thrice. So that means number again number. So number will be replicated thrice. Now the next, there is a print statement, means cursor will move to the next line. Yes, cursor came to the next line. Now the next for loop iteration, x will get the next key. Which is the next key here? Next key is A. So A will be the next key and that will be there in the variable x. Print x. Print x means what will be displayed? A will be displayed. Colon. Yes, its colon is there. And D1 of x. How much is D1 of x? D1 of A. What is this D1 of A? D1 of A means it is string. It is string. And again, on the next print statement, D1 of x into 3. So that means that D1 of x means D1 of A. What is this D1 of A? String. String will be replicated. So you will get the answer string, string, again string. Same way, the next one also you will get here. 1,2 is the key, colon, its value will be tuple. Its value is tuple. Then that same tuple will be replicated. So you will get the tuple thrice. It is thrice. So this is the answer for that question. One more time, you try out the same program in Python. Then you will get more idea about this one. Here you have to change this as the small letter D. That is all about that question. See the next question. Next question is find the output again. Box, it is an empty dictionary. Jars is equal to another dictionary. So there are two dictionaries are there, box and jars. Next, this is another dictionary. Crates is another dictionary. And here box of biscuit is equal to 1. Biscuit is the key. In box dictionary, biscuit is the key and its value will be 1. And on the next line, it is written box of cake equal to 3. Means, yes, dictionary will be coming like this. I can write box is the dictionary, which is equal to dictionary is coming like this. And the first key is biscuit. First key is biscuit and its value will be 1, comma. Again, box of cake equal to 3. That means its key will be cake and its value will be 3. That is all about that box dictionary. So you will get that box dictionary in this way. Now see that the next dictionary. Next dictionary is crates. Crates of box is equal to box. So here I can write crates is like this. This is the next dictionary. Yes, crates is equal to in this one. The first key is box. Key is box. So you can write box is the key. And its value. Its value is box. The value of this box is box itself. What is this box? Box is another dictionary. Here the first two box is the key and its value is this box. This box is a variable name. So that means this box is a dictionary itself. So you can write the value as another dictionary. See that I can write biscuit colon 1 comma cake colon 3. So this is another dictionary is value of the key box. This much all of you understood? Then comma. Next. So here it is written crates of jar. Jar is the next, jars is the next key. Yes, jars is the next key. And it's written jars on the right side, jars. What is this jars? Jars is another dictionary which consists of one element. Which is there in the question itself. So that is another dictionary. And you can write jam colon 4. That is another dictionary. And it is enclosed in the bracket. Now the next line. Yes, now you can close this dictionary. Crates dictionary is closed. And on the next line, print length of crates of box. You are finding out the length of crates of box. So this is your crates dictionary. And box is the key. And so crates of box means you will get this dictionary as the answer. So that means inside the bracket, inside the length bracket, you will get this dictionary. Understood? You will get this dictionary inside this bracket. Now you are finding out the length. Length means number of elements present in that dictionary. So how many elements are here in this dictionary? You have two elements. Don't count it key and value together. Just check how many keys are there. So there are two keys are there. So they have two elements are there in the dictionary. So that is all about that question. So the answer what you are expecting here is two. All of you understood? This is a special type of question. Just go through the question once again. And see the next question. Next question is this one. Given the dictionary, this one. Create a dictionary with opposite mapping. That is, write a program to create a dictionary as in this way. See, this is the dictionary is given. And using a program, this dictionary you have to change is this way. That means in this dictionary, K1 is the key and V1 is the value. When it commits in the inverted X, V1 is the key and K1 is the value. So you have to exchange. There, a key in the original dictionary, keys you have to take it here as the value. And in the original dictionary value, we have to take it here as the key. That is the only difference. Check it, you understood or not? You can try out the program. It's just you have to write a program. It's written there, write a program to create a dictionary as. So it's again given the dictionary. Dictionary is given there. You just want to create another dictionary from the existing one. So I will open Python here. And which is the given dictionary? The given dictionary is this one. X is equal to. This is a given dictionary. I'll copy that one. And here I can write. So this is the given dictionary. I'll change this codes. Otherwise, yes, this is a given dictionary. From the given dictionary, you have to change the key and value. Key you have to change as value and value you have to change as key. That is the question. So I am going to start the program. For K in X. For K in X. You will get the keys of the dictionary X. Understood all of you? When you use a for loop like this, you will get the keys of the dictionary X. from the dictionary x, we are extracting the key and which will be there in the variable k. And I can write one variable p is equal to x of k, x of k. That means for the key k, whatever the value is given, which will be there in the variable p. All of you understood? So now this p variable will contain the value v1. This k will contain the key k1. All of you understood now? So this for loop will give you the keys of this dictionary. And what I written is p equal to x of k. So this p will contain the value of k. Value of k means k will contain the key k1 and its value v1. So that means p will contain v1 and k will contain k1. Now we have to invert it. So I am going to invert. Invert is my dictionary name, new dictionary name. Invert of x. This must be underscore. So invert of x of. Can you say what I will write inside the bracket? So you have to take the value of the first dictionary as the key here. Where is the value of the first dictionary? In which variable? Identify the variable where I stored the value of the first dictionary. Yes, the value of the first dictionary is in variable p, which is equal to its key. Key is there in the variable k. So the same way the for loop will be repeated, and which will be reversed and stored inside the variable invert c, invert x. Now I can print it. Print INVER underscore x. So just run and see the answer. So it will check it. It's inversed or not. Inverted or not. Yes, there is an error is there. Invert x is of p is equal to is not defined. Yes, I can define. I didn't declare that one. I'll write it here. INVER underscore x is equal to a dictionary, empty dictionary. Now just run the program. You can see the answer like this. See that v1 is the key, k1 is the value. V2 is the key, k2 is the value. Again the same thing. So that is all about that question. Go through the question, go through the program once again. Now we can see the next question. What is the next question? Given two dictionaries, say d1 and d2. Write a program that lists the overlapping keys of two dictionary. That is, if a key D of D1 also a key of D2, then overlapping is there. You have to check keys of D1 is present in D2 or not. If it is present, then you can give a message overlapping. Understood all of you? There are two dictionaries are there. It's given there in the question, given two dictionary. So that means two dictionaries are given there. You don't want to accept the values from the user. And write a program that lists the overlapping keys of the dictionary. Check if the keys of the first dictionary is present in the second dictionary or not. If it is present, then you can give the message overlapping. Otherwise, you don't want to give any message. So that is all about that question. I'll start here program here. There are two keys, two dictionary. So I am going to write D1 is equal to, I'll write it 1 colon 100, comma 2 colon 200, 3 300, 4 400. This is one dictionary. I am going to define the second dictionary D2 is equal to, I'll write it as 2 200. It will check only for the key values. Comma 6 600, comma 4 400, and comma 9 900, 9 colon 900. See, there are two dictionaries are there. As in my question, given two dictionaries mentioned. That is why I didn't accept the values of keys and value. Two dictionaries are given. That means you just mention two dictionary inside the program itself. You don't want to accept the values from the user. Now we have to check the keys of the first dictionary is present in the dictionary 2. Keys of the first dictionary is 1, 2, 3, and 4. You want to check any of this key is present in the second dictionary or not. So for that I am going to use for T in D1. What you will get in T? All the keys will be present inside the variable T now. One by one, you will get the keys of D1 inside the variable T. Now, I am going to check if T in D2. You are checking whether that T is present in D2 or not. D2 is a dictionary. This in operator will check whether the specified value present in the second dictionary as key. In operator will check the specified value present in the dictionary as key. So it will check whether this key is present in D2 or not. If it is present, I can say the message print overlapping. Overlapping, and along with I am going to display which key is overlapping. Just T is overlapping. You can say T. So T is the key you are checking in D2. If it is there, then you are saying D that is present there. Now run the program and see the answer. It's overlapping 2 and 4. 2 and 4 is present in that second dictionary also. That is all about that question. Now see the next question. Write a program. See that this write a program that create a third tuple after adding two tuples. That means add second after the first tuple. Add second after the first tuple. You have to create a third tuple. How can you create the third tuple? Add the content of the first tuple into third. After then, add the content of the second tuple into the third. All of you understood? So you have to create two tuples. Create two tuples. After then, copy the values from the first tuple to the third tuple. Same way, copy the values from second tuple to the third tuple. That is the way you have to create a third tuple. Now, I will open this Python screen. The question is, you have to create a dictionary, create a tuple. So I am going to create the tuple T1 is empty tuple, and one more T2 is another empty tuple. Two different tuples are there, empty tuples. First, I am going to accept the values for the first tuple T1. Accept the values for the first tuple T1. So procedure is same, what we normally using in your program. I am going to use the same procedure, same logic. So here this is not a dictionary, it's a tuple. So only one value is needed. I can write T1 equal to K comma. So this is the way you are adding an element into the tuple. If it is a single element, you have to end with a colon. Otherwise, that will be considered as an integer value. It is not considered as a value in the tuple. If you want to add a single element into the tuple, that element must be enclosed inside the bracket and end with a comma, which we studied in that chapter. So now T1 is created. Now you can display create a tuple is here I can say T1. So T1 is created. All of you understood? Now the same way I am going to create T2 also. Same method I am going to create the T2. So I can copy this here, and here this is T2 tuple. And here also this is T2 tuple. So I'll run the program and show you this much. Here, enter the key. Do you want to continue? Yes. Again, again is yes, no. So that k tuple is created. See then, I didn't use it here. You have to say t equal to t1 equal to, sorry, you have to say, how will you write? Can you say t1 equal to t1 plus, along with the existing tuple, you are adding a new key. Same way here also, what do you want to write? Can you say it is t2 plus? Run the program and see the answer. The first value 3. Do you want to continue? Yes. Next is 3. Yes. Next is 1. So this is no. This is a tuple that is created. The tuple that is created 371. Same way you can create the second tuple also. So I am going to enter the value 9. Yes. And enter the value 7. No. You got the second tuple also. Now the next step, you have to take each element from the first tuple, copy into the third tuple. Simple procedure. So we need a third tuple. I am going to use the third tuple here as T3 equal to empty tuple. Now take all the elements from T1 tuple. How it is possible? How can you take the elements from T1 tuple? You can use a for loop. For P in T1, that will extract the values from, see, okay, that will extract the values from T1 tuple. The first value will be there in the variable P. On the second iteration, you will get the second value from the in the variable P. That you have to add to the third tuple. So the same procedure, T3 equal to T3 plus. Which element you have to add? Element P, you have to add it to there. Yes, that is all about that one. So now what happened? When the loop is repeated, all the elements of T1 will be copied to T3. Very good. Now, next is, I want to copy elements from T2 to T3 also. So that means I can write in T2. Yes. How will you write? How will you copy? T3 is equal to T3 plus P comma. Okay, you understood or not? First, this part, it's creating the tuple. This is copying the elements of T1 to T3. And T2, you are copying to T3. After that, I am going to print merged tuples. Can give a message like this, merged tuples. Yes, merged tuple is T3. Run the program and see the answer. So I can run this program this way. Is the first value 4, second value 8, again is next value 12. Now it is no. So you got 4, 8, and 12. See, 4, 8, and 12. Next is 90. Yes. 80. No. 90 and 80. See, 4, 8, 12. 4, 8, 12 are the elements of the first dictionary, and along with 90 and 80 subtended. So this is the merged tuple. So that is all about that question. So just try out these problems in Python screen. Okay, so remaining questions we can discuss in the next class. Thank you.